Good day to all of you. Myself, Dr. Arvind Sharma, Associate Professor in Physics, Government Dongar College, Bikaner. Today we are going to discuss about antennas used in microwave communication systems. For this, I select this very simple paper that you can easily understand types of microwave antenna and its applications by Lalit and Manas. Very simple paper written, only types of microwave antenna and its applications are explained here. So you can also go for such kind of papers, simple papers in which you can explain some basic concepts or their applications in PG levels. Okay, so let us start. Types of papers, types of microwave antenna and its applications. Types of microwave antenna. Microwave antenna classification and their applications. In paper, first of all, an abstract is given in which essence of the paper is explained. This paper represents classification of microwave antenna and its applications. Microwave antenna is a type of antenna which is operated at microwave frequency. The antennas which are operated at microwave frequencies are known as microwave antenna, and they are widely used in many practical applications also. A microwave antenna is a major system component that allows a microwave system to transmit and receive data between microwave sites. Microwave have wavelength ranging from 1 meter to 1 millimeter that you all are familiar. Microwaves are mainly used in satellite communications. Introduction. A microwave antenna is a physical transmission device. Antenna is nothing but a physical transmission device that transmits the signal used to broadcast microwave transmission between two or more locations, mainly used to convert electronic signal to electromagnetic waves. What is the role of antenna? Convert electronic signal to electromagnetic waves. Antenna definition. According to IEEE standard definition of terms, an antenna is any device that converts electronic signal to electromagnetic wave and vice versa effectively with minimum loss of signals. That means antenna just converts electronic signal to electromagnetic or electromagnetic to electric signal. Radiation pattern. It is the representation of field strength at a particular distance from antenna at all points in space. It consists of two principal planes, namely E plane, electric field plane, and H plane, magnetic field plane. Effective aperture. Antenna aperture is defined as the area of opening of the antenna. Opening area of the antenna is known as aperture of the antenna. Effective aperture is defined as that area through which the electromagnetic waves are transmitted, considering into account the mismatch loss, conductor dielectric losses, and polarization losses. Again, effective aperture. What is effective aperture? That area through which electromagnetic waves are transmitted. The area from which electromagnetic waves are transmitted, considering into account the mismatch losses, conductor dielectric losses, and polarization losses. Then directivity. It is defined as ratio of radiation intensity of an antenna in given direction over that and of an isotropic antenna. It is defined as the ratio of radiation intensity of an antenna in given direction over that of an isotropic antenna. It can be also defined as ratio of radiation intensity in given direction to the average radiation intensity in all direction. Directive gain or directive gain of antenna. The gain is also known as the directive gain of antenna. Gain takes account the efficiency as well as directional capabilities of the antenna. Gain is the product of efficiency and directivity. An antenna which has larger aperture will have more gain. Here we are trying to understand the topic of antenna. It is a very big topic, and many kinds of research is going on this topic. Microwave antenna is also an engineering part. So here we are only learn about the minimum principle, and minimum things according to the topic microwave antennas. So don't go through the depth in this topic if you don't have any kind of dissertation for this topic. This is a part, this is the topic you can choose for dissertation also. Otherwise, very limited things are for your classroom syllabus. Okay. So here we are trying to understand the main things, main basics of the microwave antennas. Okay. But these are many kind of things there. So at the first you are not understandable all the topics, but try to understand by reading them 2-3 times. Antenna beam area. It is denoted by omega A. It is the solid angle. Antenna beam area through which all the radiated power by an antenna would flow if power maintains its maximum value over omega A and zero elsewhere. It is also defined as the angle subtended by half power point in the main lobe in two principal planes. Z. Antenna lobes. What are antenna lobes? An antenna can neither radiate all of the energy in one particular direction, nor can it radiate equally in all directions. Antenna can neither radiate all of the energy in one particular direction, nor can it radiate equally in all directions. Often peaks are formed in the radiated energy. These peaks are called lobes. Often peaks are formed in the radiated energy and these peaks are known as lobes. The direction where maximum energy is radiated contains the major lobe. Maximum energy radiated, that is known as major lobe. The lobe just opposite to the major lobe is known as the back lobe. The lobe just opposite to the major lobe is known as back lobe. All the remaining lobes in the remaining directions are called as side lobes. Major lobe, back lobe, and side lobes. Classification of antenna. Antennas can be classified on the basis of frequency, aperture, polarization, radiation. Okay, so there are many kinds of classification are possible because antenna is a very big part, a very big area for research. Here we are only discussing about frequency classification. That is also useful for your class. VLF antenna, LF antenna, HF antenna, VHF antenna, and microwave antenna, because our part is microwave antenna. Antennas used in microwave communications. Microwave antenna, that is frequency classified antenna. An antenna which is operated at microwave frequency is known as microwave antenna. There are various types of antenna which have numerous applications. The following different types of microwave antennas are commonly used: microstrip patch antenna, horn antenna, parabolic antenna, plasma antenna, and MIMO antenna. Microstrip, horn, parabolic, plasma antenna, and MIMO antenna. All are different research areas. All five areas are for research also, horn antenna. Horn antenna are a natural evolution of the idea that any antenna represents a region of transmission between guided and propagated wave. Horn antenna is natural evolution of idea that any antenna represents a region of transition between guided and propagation waves. So generally horn antenna is connected to the feed at the rear and are flared outwards. Conical horn antenna is given here in this figure. Waveguide, flared horn and signal. This shape, flared horn, this shape is known as flared horn. Conical horn area, the shape of this is like as conical. The feed is given by waveguide. The feed is given by waveguide. Horn antennas are possible in many shapes. Rectangular, circular, elliptical. There are many kinds of shapes possible for horn antenna. The best pattern of radiation, narrow main lobe and low side lobe are obtained by making length of the horn large as compared to the aperture width. The best patterns of radiation, narrow main lobe and low side lobe are obtained by making length of the horn large as compared to the aperture width. But the space occupied by antenna should also be taken into consideration. Thus, while designing, there is a trade-off between size and aperture width. There should be trade-off between size and aperture area. Okay. Microstrip antenna. The first practical antenna were developed in 1970s. Since then, microstrip antenna have been extensively researched and developed. Because microstrip antenna is a very popular part for researchers, basically for engineers. Some physicists are also working in this field. This is because the structure of a microstrip antenna is a radiating metallic patch in a thin film. This is the structure of microstrip antenna. This is ground plane. After that, this is substrate, ground, substrate, and different geometrical patches can be here on the substrate. Microstrip feed. This is known as microstrip feed. So this is the shape of microwave antenna. Three layer, ground plane, substrate and patch. Okay. The structure of a microwave antenna is a radiating metallic patch. This patch is metallic on a thin grounded dielectric medium. Ground is of dielectric material. This is thin. These antennas are generally available in a rectangular and circular shape. The possible shapes of microstrip antenna is rectangular and circular. The patch is generally made from conducting materials like copper and gold. These antennas are based on photolithographic technology. Photolithographic technology is an experimental technique for the fabrication of antenna. That is, the patch as well as the feed lines are photoized on the dielectric substrate. Microstrip patch antennas have become a part of revolution in the electronics industry due to the developments in large-scale integration. These antennas are helpful in eliminating the disadvantages of bulkiness and expensiveness of regular engine. Microstrip antenna, and after that plasma antenna, parabola antenna. Before that, there are some applications are given here. Applications, global positioning satellite. We just go for parabolic antenna first. That is given in between that. Parabolic antenna. These are the applications for horn antenna, global positioning antenna, satellite, paging, cellular phones. After that, third one is parabolic antenna. A parabolic antenna is also known as reflector. It has a curved surface with cross section of a parabola. It is also known as dish antenna, that is used by you in your homes, parabolic dish. Its basic construction is such that the feed is directed to the vertex of the parabola and the feed itself is placed at the focus, thus giving a very high reflectivity. Very high directivity. As directivity is directly proportional to the gain, its gain is also high. Because directivity is high, hence gain is high. Parabolic reflectors are used for high frequencies. This is because narrow beam widths can be achieved by using a reflector much larger than the wavelength. So for realized size of antenna, smaller wavelengths or very high frequencies are preferred. Thus, microwaves are ideal for use these types of antennas. Applications used for higher power gains, point-to-point communication, radio telescope, television signals, satellite communication. And this is the figure of parabolic antenna. This is the shape of your dish antenna that you used at your home, and direction of waves. And this is known as LNB, parabolic reflector. Plasma antenna. A plasma antenna is a column of ionized gas. This is the shape of plasma antenna, that is very tough, but you can understand about a general understanding you can develop. A plasma antenna is a column of ionized gas which uses plasma as a medium instead of metal components. The electron behavior of plasma antenna is completely different from that of metal antenna. In the plasma antenna, the functioning concept of all together different. It is due to electrons in free space rather than electrons moving freely. One fundamental distinguishing feature of a plasma antenna is that gas ionizing process can manipulate resistance. When deionized, it has infinite resistance and hence it does not react with radio frequency. When ionized, it will have some resistance due to which it will react with electromagnetic waves. Plasma can be made to appear and disappear according to the signal frequency applied to the antenna. So this is the shape, ground and coupler, folder, plasma, and this is glass tube that is used gas inside here. Features and applications. Number 1, reflector. Number 2, staking. And number 3, high speed digital communication. Number 4, mobile industry. These are the feature applications. You just go for it. MIMO antenna. MIMO antenna in radio, what is MIMO? Multiple input, multiple output. MIMO is multiple input and multiple output. Is the use of multiple antennas as both the transmitter and the receiver and to improve communication performance. The multiple signals arrive at the receivers at different times in different phases, depending on the different paths they take. Some signals will be direct, others via multiple different paths. With this special multiplexing, each signal is unique as defined by the characteristics of the path it takes. The unique signatures produced by each signal over the multiple paths allow the receivers to sort out the individual signals using algorithms implemented by DSP signal. The same signals from different antennas then can be combined to reinforce one another, improving signal to noise ratio and therefore reliability and range. These are MIMO antennas, and this is the shape of multiple channel model illustration. These are very different technical words are used here because antenna technology is quite different. So just to remember the many things which are you not go through the in depth to understand it, because the area is very wide, we can't cover the all topics here. So we are only superficially understand the principle of antenna, principle of features and applications. Wi-Fi 802, RFID mesh networks applications are explained here. Okay, so in briefly, you can understand about the classification of antenna and their basic things, what are these and what are the main things you are using in here. Okay. After that, conclusion. In this paper, every paper at last, results and conclusions are discussed. Microwave antenna as an essential part of wireless communication. Had an overview, what are microwave antenna and the applications of for the same, understanding from the scratch the terms and definition. The antenna discussed are used in various applications, mainly radar and satellite communications. So we try to understand this topic, microwave antennas used in microwave communication systems, through this a very simple paper. So because this paper includes in very simple way the all things that you can need for your class. Okay, thanks to all of you.